those magnificent men in their flying machines. They go up to the up, up, they go down to the up, down.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I wasn't going to bother putting anything on today, but I'm that pleased with this bit. I just thought I'd put it on whilst I'm making the exhaust. And bear with the music because I can't turn it off with the one in the house. Anyway, if you look closer to this bit, I know it's nothing like it, but it's close enough for me. This is just a bit of old threaded bar, 2mm threaded bar. And I'll try to emulate what's on there if you can see it. And that's the best I can get off the picture. Right. So I thought, well, I'll do that whilst I was waiting for the wood to dry. For the exhaust, obviously that's the exhaust ports. This bit here is just a boggle that you put for your hair. One of these, stretched over and glued on with fabric glue, which will stick anything. This stuff, I might as well show you. Incredibly sticky, and it is amazing. So that'll do that. Then you just paint it. And what I tend to do is I usually get a spray and hang on. Got a bit of way to turn this off. That'll do. Right, so you get, I usually use the top of the spray can, spray the paint in and brush it on. So it's the same effect, rather than masking. Okay, so that's how I do that. And obviously a bit of rigging there, which is nickel elastic, I'd call it. For that. And then what I do with these, I'll colour code them in with the brown. Again, spray a bit in the tin, in the lid. And paint them over with a brush. This bit here, that's the sights, which are there. I know this picture's awful, but if I go through them, I'll probably try and get in there to do it. Bear with us, because I'm not really clued up. Right. See, as you can see, thanks to Mr. I think it's Andrew Fenwick, he put them on there for me, so I can get an idea of how to do them. So there's the, I've gone by that there. So that's there. You know, I mean, if this was quarter scale, then I would be it'd be a lot more detailed and a lot more better. And again, if I'd seen these pictures before I started building it, I would have put the see-through bit in, as I did with the sock with part I built. But I didn't have the pictures at the time, so obviously I've got to work on the machine gun when that comes. But that, like you say, there's the sight. If you can see it, there. So there's your sight. So I'm going by that, and then I've done my version of it, which is, this is a piece of curtain rail cut off, and it just happens to have that bobbly bit at the end, which is handy. And this is a bit of just brass tubing that I've made up, and that's a little 1mm threaded bar with a bar of tubing through it, so that I can clip the gun bit on, because don't forget, you've got to take the wing on and off, and I'm trying to make it as easy as possible to take the wing and that off and on, you know. So that's the idea of that. Hence as well, when it comes to doing the exhaust, sadly, because you've got to get this front bit off, the whole front bit's got to come off to get access to the engine. So I'm going to have to, when the exhaust is like a piece of bar like that, yeah, a bit of valves. And what I'm going to do is I've looked at the exhaust on there, and I'm going to chop it once it's all in position, and just cut through it and put a little ring round the top where my thumb is, so that I've got access to get this off, and that bit will be solid on the fuse, if you know what I mean. And then that way, at least it'll look like one bit until you come off. And some gentleman, bless him, asked me if this thing was ever made to fly. I thought, well, it's kind of obvious with this sticking out the exhaust and the engine that it's really made to fly, you know. It's like, it's not a model, static model, Jesus, all this work. So this is close. And then Mr. Alan Ball, yeah, my pilot, bless him, he's coming in, being one of the nice famous World War One fighter pilots, ace pilot. So he'll sit in there quite nicely once he's painted up and stuck in. He's handy. And if you are, in case you're wondering, you can get these. I got this from the models in Frodsham, Steve Webb Models, and they had he had a few in there, so I grabbed them. That's why there's two. And that's for my, when I start the sock with Camel. So everywhere, well, one part easier than trying to make them, I'll tell you that. So basically, ladies and gentlemen, that's more or less it for now. The next job, probably next Sunday when I get my day off. Oh yeah, there's the front as well. Hey, bear with us, try and move it around. So the front's there now. Oh yeah, and this bit here again, this is another bit, this is the same curtain rail as that, but this is, believe it or not, just a nut. I filled in with filler to get the exhaust, drilled the hole through the top and put it on. And that's another tip, nice. A lot of this stuff doesn't come with the kit. In fact, hardly any of it comes with the kit. So, you know what I mean? So that's the thing. So that's more or less it. And of course, the undercarriage is there, ready to go on. It's a bit dusty now, but so you got your undercarriage. I can't wait to put that on. So it's almost there now. It's just detailing, which I think in a way I'm mad, because people will say, oh well, it's not exactly right to the one. Well, you know, this is my take on it, you know, and I can only go by the pictures that I was sent, roughly, you know. That's all I could do, ladies and gentlemen. So anyway, I'm happy with it, and it's me who's flying it, so yeah, I'm quite pleased with it so far. Oh, I might do something with the dash, I'm not sure yet. You get fed up with it, you know what I mean? I'm dying to start my top with camel, to be honest. And this is definitely the longest plane I've ever had taken to build. And it's not one of my favourites, as everyone will know. So it's just a cat. So, and by the way, I still haven't, that's only temporary, they'll come out, the gap, people were saying about the gap. Well, that's only there just to see, get an idea, you know, to get the doodads right. So, you know what I mean? I mean, you can fly through that gap. But don't worry, that'll all be sorted. Just in case another one says it. Okay, well that's it. Okay, so I think the exhaust will be dry by now. So I'm gonna have a go at putting them on next. And then the next stage after that is I'll put the wings on and formulate the machine gun that goes over the top, the Vickers, or whatever it is. And then once I've made that, I've got to make the spars as well, the wing spars. I forgot about them. And stuff, didn't it? All them things, and I forgot about them. Oh, shit, I forgot all about them. Here's me thinking I'm nearly finished. Oh, and then the rigging. And ladies and gentlemen, that's it. And then I can get on with my Sopwith camel, which is the one I'm on about. It's from 19... I don't know if I've got it in here. It's probably hidden up there somewhere down here. I don't know where it is. But it's the one I said, it's from 1974, which I think is pretty cool. Okay. Alright, that's that. But this is as close as I can get it to the real thing. Getting into the engine, like, so it's got, like, you know, people are a bit concerned about the engine overheating because there's not enough ventilation. Well, you know, I'm just thinking, well, it's not quite finished, but if you've got all that at the front and underneath, and bearing in mind, you've also got underneath there, you got that for the bottom plate, and if need be, because that's only thin, you could drill some holes in there, and then with the front cowling here, you've got the radiator grills here on the front, like so. So you could obviously, like, if you really want, you could put cut out a few vents in there, you know, so they all go on. So I mean, I don't see it being a problem personally, you know. That's how it is on the model. So yeah, I'll see how it goes, you know. But yeah, I'm glad of the concern, but I'm not bothered about it. But I'm so chuffed with these wheels. Yes, absolutely. And then the project I've got planned is a big secret at the moment, because I'm just waiting to get it all together, if that makes sense. Right, I'm off to get a cup of coffee, and then later now, judging by the time, it's what, half 10, half 11 even. So I'm going to put a bit of detailing on this fuse, see where I can go with it. Yeah, why not? Cool. My last day off for about 3 weeks. I'm going to make the most of it. Okay, guys, chaps and girls, bye. Those magnificent men, those magnificent